the truth that there is a God and his name is Jesus, and he wants to have a relationship with you. I want to ask you, if you die tonight, do you know where you're going? So many people are going through life without knowing this answer. But Jesus said, I am the way. I am the truth. But so many people neglect him. We just use his name as a curse word. But actually, his name is the only name that can save us from this predicament, from the world, from depression, from addictions. God's name is Jesus, and he's coming back. The first time Jesus came was a preview. It was a preview telling us that God came on the earth. He came in the flesh. But even 2,000 years ago, so many people rejected Jesus. They wrote him off saying he's just a human being. He's just a prophet. He was just a baby in a manger. But I'm here to tell you, that was a preview. That is a preview of Jesus coming back. And I'm telling you, if this wasn't real, I wouldn't be here on the street corner to tell you that Jesus is real. Jesus is so real that he's changed so many lives down the ages. Even in the 21st century, he saved me when I was 21 years old. And that's why I stand up for Jesus today. Because I know there's somebody that needs to hear this message. It's either that I'm telling the truth, or I'm telling a lie. But I wouldn't do this if I came to you with a lie. I came here with a message to tell you that God is real, and his name is Jesus Christ. And he wants to have a relationship with you so much that he came 2,000 years ago. The author of life literally came down to earth. This is the greatest news, but so many people have missed it. And in case y'all missed it, the King of Kings came down on Christmas Day. And he loves you so much that he wants to set you free from your addiction, set you free from yourself. Because one day we're going to have a relationship with God. Yo, it's free, bro. I got the book right here that tells you everything that's going on right now. Even with the pandemic, the coronavirus, with racism, everything was already predicted. Because God knows the heart of humanity. But even though we've messed up over and over again, God still loves us. He waits for us like a patient father. And he's looking out for us, waiting for that moment to change our minds, to come back to our senses, start turning towards home. So many people are orphaned. We're all looking for love, but we're looking for love in all the wrong places. I was there 12 years ago until I met Jesus. And Jesus filled my heart so much that I didn't need drugs to satisfy myself anymore. I experienced the love of God. Right now, I'm not coming to you with a religion. I'm not coming to you with a religion. I'm talking about passion. I'm talking about life. I'm talking about a message that can save your life today. You see, whether you know it or not, we all need a relationship with God. We need a relationship with God. And God's name is Jesus. He wasn't just some historical figure. He wasn't just a baby in a manger. He wasn't just some good moral teacher. And he definitely ain't an angel. He is the Son of God. And he came 2,000 years ago. But just like so many people missed it the first time, and will have to endure hell for eternity, people are missing it today. People are getting into racism. People are getting into fear and anxiety because of the pandemic. And we're freaking out because we don't know where to go to. But Jesus said, I am the way. I am the truth. That if you come through me, you can have a relationship with God. And so today, why am I out here giving you this message? Because this message is the most important thing that you could adopt into your life today. Imagine if you didn't have Jesus. If you died right now, where would you go? You see, I can't stay silent because I got the cure for sin, and his name is Jesus. some of you watched the video. Maybe some of you guys saw the video of the cure for COVID. But you know what's more dangerous and more lethal than COVID? It's a thing called sin. It's rebellion against God. It's pride, thinking that we can accomplish everything in this life and get to heaven still. It's called deception. It's called believing in the lies that we're okay without God. That is sin. And today I got good news because there's a cure for sin. I don't know if there's a cure for COVID, but most definitely there's a cure for sin. Jesus Christ died your death and shed his blood on the cross. Can you believe that? God loved you so much that he shed his blood for you. Would the president of America shed his blood for you? Take the place, take the punishment for all the wrong that you've done? Probably not. He doesn't even know your name. But Jesus Christ, who is God, he knows you by name. He knows you by name. And he knew your past and he still died for you. He knows what you've done in your life and he still died for you. This is my Jesus. This is my Jesus. And right now, what we need in America is Jesus. The solution for racism. The solution for the pandemic. The solution for fear and anxiety is Jesus. Because Jesus died for all that. And he resurrected from the grave. And so nothing is impossible. If you're facing fear and anxiety, if you're facing suicidal thoughts, if you're facing depression, give your heart, give your life to Jesus today. Turn away from that life. Believe in Jesus, the person of God, and he'll give you a brand new life. I promise you, that's what he did for me 12 years ago. That's why I can't stop. This is why I won't stop. This is why I gotta preach it. This is why I gotta tell you that this 70-80 year internship, this life is just an internship, y'all. It's just a preview. But we're just so caught up in this life when there's an eternal life that God wants to live with you with. So if you die today, do you know where you're going? And if you can't answer that question, the answer is Jesus. Because there's only one man who claimed to be God. And his name is Jesus. And he died and he resurrected from the grave. I want to ask you, who do you know? Who do you know has done this? Who can resurrect from the dead other than Jesus? You go to Israel right now, there's an empty tomb. There's an empty tomb. Jesus rose again from the dead. And so many of us, we've never even heard this message. That's why I'm here today to tell you that there is a God who is for you. He knows where you are, where you've been. He knows the things you've done. And he loves you even in your darkest moments. That if you're going through a dark moment right now, I promise you, just like Jesus met me 12 years ago, he'll meet you too. Because he's alive. See, what I'm talking about right now is life. It's life. I'm not coming to you with a religion. I'm coming to you with the kingdom of God. And the king is Jesus. And he wants to have a relationship with you. And so it's easy to start a relationship with God. Repent. Turn from your sin. Renounce your sin. Renounce your unbelief in Jesus. Denounce your sin. Denounce your failures. Turn away from your habitual sins that has been bringing guilt and shame in your life. And I promise you, believe in Jesus today. He'll forgive you. He'll give you a brand new life. Jesus is the way. And his power has not changed. If you're addicted to drugs, if you're addicted to alcohol, you're in a place of suicidal thoughts and depression, I'll be here on the street corner for about the next 15 minutes. And I'll pray for you. I'll pray with you. You see, I want to tell you guys, this is just a preview. If you all think I'm wrestling fellas right now, and it almost feels like I'm telling you to believe in Jesus, and it's making you uncomfortable, just wait when Jesus comes back. Then you'll be happy. You'll be happy that there was a street preacher who talked about Jesus before Jesus came. You see, Jesus is going to come back as much as he came the first time. And when he came the first time, so many people missed it. God came in the flesh, but so many people missed it. And even Christians, Amen. Even Christians, we say we love Jesus, but we look like the world. We look like people who don't even believe in him. And so today I'm making a stand for Jesus. Because this is the only way. This is the only way to salvation. What does salvation mean? It means that you receive the love of God and you start a relationship with him today, and he'll save you from your past. He'll save you from your old life. If this resonates with your heart, find me on Instagram, Arrow Movement, and I'll help you get baptized. Bury your old life. Bury that old life of unbelief in Jesus. Bury that old life of doubts. Bury that old life of sin. Bury that old life of guilt and shame. You were never designed to carry all of that yourself.